musicians of the Staunton Music Festival performing at Trinity Episcopal Church, just down the street a little bit from us here at Christ Lutheran Church in Staunton, Virginia, USA, the home of Bach Around the Clock 2021, our fifth year sharing the glorious music of Bach with you on the day, the Saturday closest to his birthday. His birthday happens to fall tomorrow, March 21st, also happens to be the first day of spring. So a nice excuse for us to all get together and celebrate Bach's music. Now, in this next hour, we're going to, of course, hear some more preludes and fugues played both by our Heifetz Institute faculty members as well as in these new string quartet arrangements by Nicholas Kitchen of the Borromeo Quartet. Number 9, if you're keeping track, is what's up in this hour. After that, though, we're going to cast our eyes, well, if not heavenward, at least up towards the loft, the organ loft here at Christ Lutheran, which boasts a magnificent Taylor and Booty tracker organ. Taylor and Booty is a renowned organ builder right here in Staunton, actually, just a little ways out of town. And you're going to be hearing some of the great organ works by Bach, played by Florence Jowers, who happens to be the music director here. The title of this program is Toccatas, Fantasies, Preludes, and Fugues, Oh My. And yes, you will be hearing all of them coming up after our first segment of Preludes and Fugues. Kicking off with our faculty pianist, Lynne Mackey, actually I should say faculty keyboardist, Lynne Mackey, performing at the harpsichord. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, and good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, whatever time it is that you've chosen to watch this 2021 virtual version of Bach Around the Clock. I'm Florence Jowers, organist at Christ Lutheran Church in Staunton, and one of the co-founders of Bach Around the Clock. I'm sorry, because of the pandemic, we had to cancel this event in 2020, but happy that we've learned enough in the last year about technology to enable us to bring this 2021 festival into your homes. I say we, but it is all Ben Rowe of the Heifetz Institution, who is the brains and oftentimes the brawn to make this happen. Facilitated by Ben, you are hearing performances this year which were recorded in many places around the country, but I'm playing this recital here at Christ Lutheran Church on the beautiful Opus 24 Taylor & Booty organ built right here in Staunton. I've titled this program Toccatas, Preludes, Fantasias, and Fugues, oh my. In fact, I'm playing one of each of these major works of Bach separated by movements of his beautiful Pastorale. All of these pieces were written when Bach was young and serving as court organist in Weimar between the ages of 23 and 32. His youthful exuberance and creativity certainly are exhibited in these large-scale free organ works. I will begin with BWV 538, Toccata and Fugue in D minor, the Dorian, not the more famous Phantom of the Opera D minor toccata. Bach was influenced at this time by Italian concerto style, which you can easily hear in the staccato as it moves rapidly back and forth between the differing colors of the two manuals. And the fugue harkens back to an even earlier Italian style, that of the motet fugue. In this fugue, Bach demonstrates what an expert he is in writing counterpoint that is mind-boggling in its complexity, yet holds your interest with its beauty. Following the Dorian Toccata and Fugue, I will play Bach's more mature and sedate Pastorale, BWV 590. No manuscript survives of this piece, and it wasn't even published until the middle of the 19th century, but it was very popular with Mendelssohn and other 19th century composers and recitalists. There are four movements in this piece. Although Bach did not name them, the movements have traditionally been called Siciliana, Allemande, Aria, and Gigue. Not too much is known about this composition or the use of this piece originally, but it is thought to have been written sometime after 1720, and it has been suggested that perhaps Bach used the movements of this piece as interludes in his Christmas oratorio. So I will begin by playing the first two movements, Siciliana, the one movement that brings to mind the pastoral scenes of Christmas, and the Allemande, following the Dorian, Toccata, and Fugue.
Thank you.
the very familiar Great Fantasy and Fugue in G minor, BWV 542. The Fantasy and Fugue were written at different times and, in fact, not paired together until 1844. But what a pairing. The Fantasy has been compared to a massive granite building with a rigid, cold facade. Its explosive bursts of energy and its complex harmonies offer an amazing contrast to the perpetual motion of the fugue. Hold on, because once the fugue starts, there's no stopping until the final chord.
Thank you. Live chamber music returns to Staunton with the Spring Eternal Concert Series. Four programs featuring the young masters of the Heifetz Ensemble in Residence, presented in a safe and socially distanced setting in the newly opened Great Hall of the Blackburn Inn and Conference Center, or available to view online in real time and on demand. Information at heifetzinstitute.org. Major support for the Heifetz International Music Institute is provided by Mary Baldwin University, the National Endowment for the Arts, the Virginia Commission for the Arts, and the Community Foundation of the Central Blue Ridge. For a complete list of our supporters, sponsors, and in-kind donors, please visit heifetz.institute/donors. We thank them and you for supporting our mission to enable the next generation